With so much to do during very short stays on the moon, Apollo astronauts wore checklists on their wrists. I'm Amy Shearer Title, and today on Vintage Space, we're talking about the famous, or perhaps infamous, not-so-safe-for-work Apollo 12 wrist checklists. In preparing for Apollo 12's mission, it fell to the backup crew, Dave Scott, Jim Irwin, and Al Warden, to prepare the checklist for the prime crew. These books were made of 3.5-inch square spiral-bound pages tied to the astronaut's wrist using a strap. And like all hardware and flight suits, the crew didn't train with their actual flight checklists. They trained with other models, meaning that they didn't see the one the backup crew prepared for them until they were actually doing an EVA on the moon. When Commander Pete Conrad and Lunar Module Pilot Al Bean began their EVAs, they noticed that there were small cartoon drawings in the checklist, dogs going through mission events. There was also a play on words. Al Bean was told to check out the Lunar Albino instead of Albedo, a play on his own name. But most famously, the Apollo 12 backup crew snuck some Playboy Playmates into the Apollo 12 prime crew's wrist checklists. It was at the end of the first EVA, after the core tube sampling and before re-entering the lunar module, that Al Bean's checklist showed a picture of Cynthia Myers, Playboy's pick for Miss December of 1969. Under her picture was the caption, "Don't forget, describe the protuberances." There were three more Playmates stuck inside the two astronauts' checklists. Pete Conrad found Angela Dorian, Miss September of 1967, over the capture, "Seen any interesting hills and valleys?" And Miss October of 1967, Reagan Wilson, with the caption, "Preferred tether partner." Bean, meanwhile, found Leslie Bianchini, Miss January of 1969, in his checklist with the instructions to survey her activity. The moonwalking astronauts, knowing their words would be broadcast to the world, managed not to react when they saw the pictures, at least not on the open mic loop. And if you want, you can actually buy a replica of the Apollo 12 wrist checklist. For more on the wrist checklist and some of the pranks snuck into those pages, check out the latest article on Vintage Space, linked below. Leave your questions and comments below, and for daily space updates, most of them vintagey, follow me on Twitter as AST Vintage Space. And don't forget to subscribe right here so you never miss an episode.